There are a few accessories you can buy that extend the functionality of the Capture device. The first of these is the Capture Module Timer, which allows you to shoot time-lapse and long exposure photography and video, self or interval timer photography, and also to control the exposure count. We have a number of options when using the timer function. First, make sure batteries are in and turn on the module timer. The display is broken down into hours, minutes, and seconds, and you can change these by first pressing the set button, then using the up-down buttons, moving between the options using left or right on the trackpad. This function is really useful for creating time-lapse videos from individual stills, so we'll use this as an example of how we would set up the device. Other examples are available in the manual, which you can download from the links provided. You could use this system with a flash, but we want a long exposure on bulb mode, so this won't be necessary, and we're going to attach the receiver directly onto the camera. You can remotely trigger both the camera and flash simultaneously, but you will need two capture sets to do this. A receiver and the transmitter should be attached to the camera, with a second receiver attached to the base of the flash, to ensure they are working perfectly in sync. So, looking at the module, delay specifies the delay before shooting starts. In this example, we won't need a delay, so this is set to zero. For the long option, if we were going to shoot individual shots and not on bulb or continuous mode, we would set this to zero. And for a continuous burst of photos, set the camera to continuous mode and then set the duration of the burst using long. But for this example, we're setting the camera to bulb mode, so we can shoot in the low light conditions at dusk, and we're going to set this to 1 second. Interval 1 sets the gap between shots, and we're going to set this to 2 seconds. You may be wondering, why not just use the video functionality of the camera? Combining a series of photographs to form a video means we have complete control over the length of the exposure, which on this camera is limited to 1/30th of a second when shooting PAL video at 25 frames per second. This approach means we can bring in over 30 times more light into the camera, essential when shooting in difficult conditions. It also means the end resolution is going to be much higher, so we can crop, reframe, or even zoom right into some of the detail if we want to. Interval 1N sets the number of shots for interval 1. In this example, we want a 10-second video at a PAL frame rate in the UK of 25 frames per second, so we're going to set this to 250. Interval 2 controls the gap between running the cycle again, so you could set a delay of 8 hours, for example, so that it would shoot dawn in the morning as well. But instead, we're going to set this to 1. Interval 2N controls the number of times that you want to repeat the whole process. We're only going to set this to 1, but you could set this to 14, and the system would repeat dusk and dawn shots for a week, assuming your batteries in the camera lasted that long. When all values are set, press Start to begin the cycle. And here's a video shot using similar settings.
Watch the rest of the films in the series from the links below, or visit the Hainel website for more information on the Capture.